Developing tonight, the chancellor of UW-La Crosse has been fired, and he says it's because he made adult films with his wife and posted them online. Joe Gao had been leading La Crosse for 17 years, and just last week, the Regents heard about his online films posted on adult pages and YouTube. Janet, you spent the day looking into the story. What'd you find?
Well, Chris, Dr. Joe Gao made adult films with his wife. They went on a YouTube channel called Sexy Healthy Cooking. And in them, he and his wife made vegan meals with adult film stars. And they also went on a pornographic website.
His firing isn't the first time Joe Gao has clashed with the UW system over adult films. Something happened 5 years ago that Kelly Meyerhofer, the higher education reporter at the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, remembers well.
Back in 2018, he invited an adult film actress, Nina Hartley, to speak on campus about the adult film industry. And it was part of a free speech week. And he thought it would, you know, open people's minds to different perspectives. And the UW system did not respond well to that. They reprimanded him. They didn't give him a pay raise like all the other chancellors.
That actress didn't come, and Gao had to pay back the university the money he spent on hiring her. But his claim of free speech then is the same one he's claiming now. He told Kelly that what he and his wife did in their own free time, in his view, is protected by the First Amendment, that it was adult consensual sexuality.
I've talked to some free speech experts and sort of higher ed employment lawyers, and their sort of take on the case is, you know, maybe he doesn't have as strong of a case as he may be letting on, you know, especially when you're in a really public-facing role like that. The institution can make decisions that, you know, you're not acting in the best interest of the university.
Gao has not ruled out legal action on his own behalf, and the Board of Regents has another emergency meeting tomorrow morning, very clearly about all of this. In a statement today, UW President Jay Rothman said of Gao's actions, they cause, quote, reputational harm to the university, adding they were abhorrent. Karen Walsh, also with the UW administration, added what Gao did was alarming and disgusting.
So as of right now, Gao is out as chancellor, but he is still a tenured faculty member, and he told that journalist I spoke to he has every intention of being in the classroom at UW-La Crosse next fall. The board seems to have other plans in that regard as well, as they have asked the now interim chancellor to review his tenure status in that teaching role.
Yeah, so, Janet, Gao makes the presumption that he has First Amendment protection. We know First Amendment protects you from the federal government, but not like private employers. But this is a public university, government-funded university. Right. Is there any chance he has a case with that or no?
So a couple of things. He told Wisconsin Public Radio today, Joe Gao, that the books and videos that he made were produced as private citizens under his First Amendment right. But even so, he said having said that, he should be protected by the university policy on academic freedom and freedom of expression. And that policy explicitly does state that it protects ideas even if people disagree with them or find them repugnant. But there are institutions within the system. In this policy, it says institutions within the system may restrict expression that is otherwise directly incompatible with the functioning of the university. So do they think what he did is incompatible with the functioning of the university? We shall see.
Wow. Okay. Well, that's a talker.
Okay.
Thank you, Jenna.
You bet.